there is such a lot of what's in my camera bag videos on YouTube. But I don't think it's a bad thing, because when you're starting in videography or in photography, sometimes it can get really tricky to find what gear to buy. But anyway, those videos can be really boring. I'll try to go fast. So here we are. Today I will try to show you all the gear I use to make my videos, but I will try to go as fast as possible because those videos can be really long. First, the camera bag, Peak Design Everyday Backpack in 20 liter. I made a whole video about it. It's a really handy backpack, perfect for everyday uses, and yeah, I recommend it. Really great. A bit expensive though, but yeah, really great. Then moving on, my hard drive, this one. This is the Western Digital My Passport, 4 TB, so plenty of space in it. It's fast enough. I edit on it and it works really well. It's a bit slow to fire up, but it works well. Then it's always great to have a lens cleaning kit. So this one is from Hama. It's a bit expensive for what it is, but it does the job. Then, gimbal. I use this one. This is the Ronin-S. I already made a full video about it. It is a really great one. If you start in filmmaking, it's definitely not the first thing you wanna buy. You have to get better at filmmaking before to buy that. A tool like that won't make you a better filmmaker. It will help you, but you first have to learn the basics and to learn how to make great videos before to buy something like that. Otherwise, it will be pretty much useless. And it's a pretty expensive device, so at the beginning, I would recommend buying lenses and cameras instead of right away buying a gimbal. Moving on, now for my drone. Still the good old Mavic Pro, not the 2, because I don't fly my drone that often and this one is enough for the moment, so I'm not planning on upgrading for the Mavic 2 or the Mavic Air soon. The Mavic Pro still does the job. Some ND filters from Neewer, and the case is from Lowe Pro. Then the microphone that I use, I mostly use 2 microphones. This one and this one, which I'm recording on right now. So this is the Rode Video Micro. If you are starting in filmmaking, I would definitely recommend getting this microphone at the beginning. It's really great, not expensive, the quality is really good for the price, and it doesn't need any batteries. So, I mean, this microphone is perfect. Then when I'm making other videos, like inside, or when I'm making some voiceover, I use this better microphone. And this one can also be used as a recorder with those XLR inputs. So this one is the Tascam DR40. Then something you always need, a notebook. Every time I make a video, I first write some notes down here. And sometimes when you have nothing to do and you have to wait for someone or something, or I don't know, you can also draw things. And you know, like when you are in a boring class at school. I did this one during a class, and actually this one too, and this one too, this one too, this one too, this... Oh, okay, I do all my drawing while I'm in a classroom, but anyway, you have to kill the time. Then moving on, my pods, 2 tripods and 1 monopod. So this is the first tripod. I think it's called the Manfrotto Pixie or something. I think it's a must to have a little tripod like this one, because if you want to set a time lapse, or if you want to just to set your camera somewhere without having to carry a big tripod, this is so handy. But be careful. For example, this one with my camera with the microphone on top, sometimes it rotates, so I wouldn't put a reflex camera on this one because it's not really strong, so it's only for small mirrorless cameras. Then I have this bad boy. So this one is the monopod from Manfrotto. As you can see, it's pretty big, like really big, and it's pretty heavy. With this fluid tripod and this fluid head, you can get some pretty fluid moves, so it works well. And you can attach the gimbal at the top, so like that you have an extra handle. And my last tripod is is this one. This is the Manfrotto B3. It's in carbon fiber, really small, really lightweight, and it's perfect when you are a photographer but you want to hike and to go like in mountains and everything. So I recommend this tripod. Then when I ski or when I need another camera, I use this one. So those are the straps and everything to mount the camera like on your head. It's not a GoPro. This one is the Sony Action Cam X1000V. Honestly, it's great. It shoots in 4K, 1080p, 120 frames a second. But I do not recommend buying this one because it's the same price as a GoPro Hero 7. And the GoPro Hero 7 is better than this Sony. But we got this one about 3 or 4 years ago. And back then, it was better than the GoPros. So it's a really great action cam with a waterproof case. So then I have those two lens adapters for when I use my Nikon lenses or my lens with a M42 mount. So now the lenses. I have those two lenses with a M42 mount. This one is a Super Takumar 55mm f1.8. It's radioactive, I already talked about it in a previous video. Really great lens. This one is a Elixir Travnar 135mm f3.5. Not that sharp, but pretty cool too. Vintage lens. I thought it was a Leica at the beginning because of the cap, but it's not a Leica. And then my main lens is this one, 12mm too. 60mm, so it's a wide lens and a telephoto lens. It's f3.5, 5.6, and this is a lens from Panasonic. Yeah, you see it right there. And now the last one, my camera, which is the Panasonic Lumix G80. I got this camera about a year ago, a bit less, but something like a year ago, and it is really a great camera for the price. So I think this camera, the Lumix G80, is really, really great for beginner photographers and beginner videographers because it's a really good camera for videography and photography. So it has a 16 megapixels sensor, it has a built-in image stabilization which works super well. It's small, it is lightweight, it shoots 4K, it's really easy to use, the image quality is really great, and it's not really expensive. So even though this camera was released in 2016, I think it is still one of the best mirrorless camera for the beginners in videography and in photography. And it's even good if you are an advanced filmmaker. I mean, I use it all the time and it works really well, except for the autofocus in video, but that's not a big deal. Anyway, whew. So there you have it. This is all the stuff I use to make my videos. So yes, if you have any questions, leave them below. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, to subscribe and to share the video. I would really appreciate it. And I will see you guys in the next one.